Hi students, welcome to physical science class. Here I am Venkatesh. Today we will learn an interesting and important topic from 10th class physical science, that is refraction of light at plane surfaces. Our chapter name is refraction of light at plane surfaces. The major branch in physical science is optics. Optics means study of light. Optics means study of light. You may feel wonder to know the phenomena followed by the light. Actually, in your previous class, you have learned about reflection of light. Now, in this class, you will discuss about a refraction of light. You might have observed the phenomena like when you drop a coin in your water bath containing water, the coin actually is at the bottom of the tub, but it can be seen as a raised from the distance, some distance from the bottom. It may be appears as a raised. One more example, when you put any stick in the water bath, the stick can be appear as a standing or bent like. So next one, in the night sky you can observe the stars are twinkling, or the light which is coming from the long distance is observed as a on off on off on off. Like, what are the reasons behind the topics what I have discussed now? That is the refraction. The all things what are happening now is based on refraction. Now in this chapter we will discuss about the light, how undergoes refraction at plane surfaces, and the basic concepts related to the light. Refraction is nothing but bending of light at interface of two media, or changing of path at interface of two media, or change the speed of light at interface of two media. So refraction explains about when a light ray travels from, for example, this is water, this is air. The light in which material it is traveling considered as a medium. Medium means through which. Here the light traveling through air is a medium. Here the light traveling through water is a medium. Water is considered as a denser medium. Air is considered as a rarer medium. Okay, this is the interface of two media which is separating air and water. Now if you draw any perpendicular line, we call it as normal to that medium, which is at the right angle to the interface of two media. When a light ray travels from rarer medium to denser medium, actual path it was take is like this, but the light doesn't travel like this, it bends and travels. Or when your light ray travels from denser medium to rarer medium, you may thought this is the path of the light taken, but the light doesn't travel like this, it travels by bend some extent. Why this bending is occurring, or why this change of path is occurring? Due to change of speed of light when it travels from one medium to another medium. Actually, Fermat said that light always want to travel in a shortest path. So to fulfill that statement, the light which is traveling denser to rarer medium, it bends away from the normal. And when the light travels rarer to denser medium, it bends towards the normal. When the light travels from denser medium, the speed of light will be changed. That's why bending is occurred. Here, the speed of light is increased when it travels from denser medium to rarer medium. Here, when light ray travels from rarer medium to denser medium, its speed was decreased, so that's why it bends towards the normal. this change of speed is occurring due to change of material. Here air is the material, here water is the material. Next, how the light ray refracted when it travels from one medium to another medium. First, case one. In case one, when light ray travels from rarer medium to denser medium, what will happen? When light ray travels from rarer medium to denser medium, its speed will be decreased. So that's why it bends towards the normal. When the speed of light is decreases, it bends towards the normal. When light ray travels from denser medium to rarer medium, its speed increases. So that's why it bends away from the normal. This is the normal, this is the light ray path. So that's why it bends away from the normal due to increasing of speed. When light ray travels from denser medium to rarer medium, the speed of light is increases, the bending will takes place. Next, the light ray is incident on normal, it passes through the normal without changing its speed, without deviation and without bending. Whether it may be passing from denser to rarer or rarer to denser, it will not go bending. The incident ray makes angle with the normal, that is called as incident angle. The refracted ray makes angle with the normal, we call it as refracted angle. Here the incident angle is greater when compared to the refracted angle because it bends towards the normal. In this case, incident angle is greater than compared to the refracted angle. Here bending takes place how, like bends towards the normal. Most important bit for public examination. Speed of light is decreased. In this case, when light ray travels from rarer medium to denser medium, the incident angle is greater when compared to the refracted angle. Next, bending towards the normal. It is a very important bit for your public examination. Next is how the speed of light is changing. The speed of light is decreased in case 1. Now, in the case 2, here the incident ray makes an angle with the normal, that is called as incident angle. The refracted ray makes an angle with the normal, that is called refracted angle. In the case of 2, when the light ray travels from denser medium to rarer medium, the incident angle is less than when compared to the refracted angle. In this case, light ray bends away from the normal. In this case, light ray bends away from the normal. Next, speed of light increases. Next, in this case, incident angle is equal to refracted angle is equal to 0. Here, no bending will occur. Here, no change of speed of light. So in this case, when light ray incident on normal, it will not deviated and the incident angle, refracted angle would be 0 and no bending will occur and no change of speed of light will be occurred. This is very important case. In public examinations like this, when which condition no bending will occur, in which condition then the light ray incident on normal, otherwise bending will occur, maybe towards the normal or away from the normal. These are the very important rules for the refraction of light when it travels from one medium to another medium. The reason behind bending is explained by refractive index, which means by how much extent in this material the light ray will bend can be estimated by using the refractive index of that media. Refracting index is one of the property to the material. What is meant by refractive index? Actually, you know, the speed of light in vacuum is equal to 3×10⁸ meters per second. It is denoted with the letter C, is equal to 3×10⁸ meters per second. The speed of light in vacuum is denoted with the letter C, which is equal to 3×10⁸ meters per second. It is also very important bit for your public exam. Next, the speed of light in vacuum will not change, and this is a greatest one, and no matter when cannot travel with the speed of light. In the other medium, the speed of light will be decreased because speed of light in vacuum is the rarest one, in that speed is very greater. In the remaining mediums, the speed will be decreased. So, refractive index of the material is equal to, refractive index is defined as, it is a ratio between the speed of light in the vacuum to the speed of light in the medium. So the formula for refractive index, n is equal to speed of light in vacuum, speed of light in medium. Speed of light in vacuum is denoted with the letter C, and speed of light in the medium is denoted with the letter V. So n is equal to C by V is a refractive index of the medium. Here the refractive index of the medium is compared to the vacuum, so that's why it is called as absolute refractive index. Here the comparison of speed of light is with vacuum, so that's why this is called as absolute refractive index. The absolute refractive index depends upon what are the factors affecting the refractive index. Factors, first one is material of the medium. Next, wavelength of light used. You can measure with this formula of the refractive index of any medium. For example, now speed of light in vacuum is equal to 3×10⁸ meter per second. Now the refractive index of glass is C by V. Here C is equal to 3×10⁸ meter per second by speed of light in the glass. It is denoted with the letter V, is 3/2 meter per second. Then meter per second cancels. Here the fraction 3/2 is reverse, and it becomes as a 2/3×3×10⁸. So 3 cancels. The speed of light in glass is 2×10⁸. There is no units for the refractive index because refractive index is a comparison, or it's a ratio. Refractive index of glass is 2×10⁸. Refractive index is a comparison, that's why it has no units. Up to now you have learned about refractive index. Now Then our concept is relative refractive index. Relative means comparison. Here, relative refractive index means the comparison of refractive index of one medium to another medium. So, relative refractive index. Is equal to speed of light in medium 1 to the speed of light in medium 2. The formula to find relative refractive index is speed of light in medium 1 to speed of light in medium 2. Speed of light in medium 1 is denoted with the letter V1. Speed of light in medium 2 is denoted with the letter V2. Now, divide each speed of light with C. Here C means speed of light in vacuum. V1 by C, V2 by C. Here C is speed of light in vacuum. Speed of light in vacuum. So already you know N1 is equal to C by V1. If you write this like this, 1 by C by V1 whole by 1 by C by V2. Here 1 by C1 is nothing but 1 by N1 by 1 by C by V2 is equal to 1 by N2. If you reverse the fractions, the values becomes N2 by N1. This is the relative refractive index. The relative refractive index is denoted by refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium is equal to N2 by N1. This is the relative refractive index of one medium to the another medium. The relative refractive index is equal to speed of light in the medium 1 to speed of light in the medium 2. If you denoted the speed of light in medium 1 is V1 and the speed of light in medium 2 is V2, then try to divide the V1 and V2 with the speed of light in vacuum. Already you know refractive index is equal to speed of light in vacuum by speed of light in the medium. So if you try to write the fractions like this, it should be equal to N1, this should be equal to N2, 1 by N1 by 1 by N2. If they reverse the fractions, the value is becomes N2 by N1. So refractive index of the medium 2 with respect to medium 1 is equal to the refractive index of second medium by refractive index of first medium. This is the comparison between the two refractive indices. Some more examples you have to remember. The relative refractive index of air is 1.003 and benzene is equal to 1.50 and diamine is equal to 2.42. Remember this, very important one. What is the relative refractive index of diamond? 2.42. In your textbook, some of the materials relative refractive indexes are given. So, try to memorize those. Relative refractive index of air is 1.003, benzene is 1.50 and diamond is 2.42. Next one is Snell's law. To find the relation between the incident angle and refracted angle in a refraction, the scientist Snell's conducted an experiment and proposed a law that is called Snell's law. So we will learn this Snell's law through lab activity. So aim to find the relation between angle of incident and angle of refraction. That is the aim.
Procedure.
Actually, the white chart what you have taken Snell's law aim to find the relation between angle of incident and angle of refraction, or aim to find the relation between angle of incident and angle of refraction. Apparatus required. What are the apparatus required? Pro circle and protractor and pencil, scale, laser light, white chart. The procedure is, first of all, take the white chart and try to divide this white chart into 4 parts. Place the pro circle like this and try to draw the angles 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 like this. So it will help how the refraction will take place. This pro circle is made with glass. Now this is the laser light. You can use this laser light to conduct this experiment. So if you place the laser light like on the pro circle, it will show us. Of course, when it is incident like this, which means the angle may be 10, 30, 40, 50, the angle may be 40 degrees, which means angle of incidence is equal to 40. You take what are the respective refracted angle for this 40 degrees. It may be on to 30 like this. So try to find the relative refracted angles of the taken incident angles and try to find the sine of that angles and try to find the sine of the refracted angles. Here it may be 20, 30, 40, 50 and so on. You take means by placing the or by passing the light ray, you can find the refracted angle by how much extent it will be refracted.
Degrees. 10 degrees. 15 degrees. 20 degrees. 25 degrees. 30 degrees. 35 degrees. 40 degrees. 45 degrees. 50 degrees. 55 degrees. 60 degrees. 65 degrees. 70 degrees. 75 degrees. 80 degrees.
90 degrees. You can find the relative refracted angles of the taken incident angles and try to find the sine of that angles. At the end, you may find for every and at the last try to find the value of sin I by sin r, like that sin 20 degrees, sin 30 degrees, sin 45 degrees values. How can you find? You can find out the sin values of I, sin values of r, and try to find out the sin I by sin r values. At the end, you can find out sin I by sin r values should be a constant. You get the same values at each cases. So this constant is further equal to the relative refractive indexes, which means N2 by N1. By this, we can say that N1 into sin I is equal to N2 into sin R. This is the Snell's law. By this experiment, Snell found that N1 into sin A is equal to N2 into sin R. Or the question is asking like that, try to find out the sin A by sin R is equal to constant. Which law that is? That is Snell's law. Understand clearly? Next concept is loss of refraction. In your previous class, you have learned about loss of reflection. Like this, the first law of refraction is when you observe this is refracted, this is incident angle, incident ray, refracted ray, this is the normal. If you consider the board is a plane, the board is a plane, plane is nothing but having length, breadth only. Here the incident ray is on the board, the normal is on the board, the separating media is on the board, and the refracted ray is on the board, which means the all parts are lies in the same plane, which means the incident ray, refracted ray, and the normal lies in the same plane. This is the first law of refraction. Next one, next one is during refraction light follows Snell's law, which means N1 sin I is equal to N2 sin R. Here I is the incident angle, R is the refracted angle, and sin I, sin R is the incident, sin of incident, sin of refraction. N1 is the refractive index of the first medium, N2 is the refractive index of the second medium. These two are the laws of refraction.